One thing before we start. If your Divi website looks like this on the back end, then you're using the old Divi 4 version. Divi 5 has been released, and this is a major change in how we work with Divi. You can only download Divi 5 if you have an active license with Elegant Themes. I can get you one with 10% discount. Go to wp.discount/Divi. This link is also in the description of this video and of course in the comments. Then you have 24 hours to this discount. You can pay yearly or a lifetime license. Click over here on sign up today. If you don't want all the extras, just press on no thanks, proceed to checkout, fill in all your information over there, choose if you want to pay by card or with a bank account, agree to the terms of service and press complete registration. And then you are being locked in into the members area. Click over here to download the Divi 5 beta. Then we go over here to appearance, we go to themes, you press over here on add theme, press on upload theme, choose the file we've just downloaded from Elegant Themes and press on install now. Then you get a warning if you want to replace Divi version 4 with version 5, and then we press replace installed with uploaded. Then the next step is to go to Divi and go to Divi 5 Migrator. In here is going to check if our website is compatible with Divi 5. Well, it definitely is. 80 modules are ready to be converted. And then we press over here, migrate this side to Divi 5 and press on confirm. Well done. Now we can continue this video. If you want to edit your pages with Divi 5, you can do this in two ways. You can go to pages, all pages. And from here, you can go to any page you want and press on edit with Divi. There's also another way, go to the front end of your website, just browse to any page that you want to change and click over here on edit with Divi. Divi works with sections, inside the sections are rows and inside those rows you can place any module that you want. If you hover over your modules, you can go to settings or you can just click on it. Then on the right side, you will see all your modules and you can change the content of this specific module. But every single module or row or section has these three tabs: content, design, and advanced. Here we can change anything we want on our specific module. But if you just quickly want to change some text, click on the module and click on it again, and you can start typing directly to change this specific module. It's that easy. With sections, you can create any layout you want inside of Divi. You can just go over here into a section. This is a section. You can duplicate it, trash it, or you have even more options. But if you scroll down, you can also add in your own sections. If you press on this plus icon, you can see these sections with already a lot of layouts predefined for you. This way, you can build anything you want with any kind of layout using the newest CSS features. So it's always really fast. If this is not enough, you can also generate a section with AI, or you can even choose one of these. You can add in all kinds of modules that you want, but on the right side, you can also go to layout and you can change the horizontal gap. Look at how it moves. The vertical gap, you can change the column widths. You can do anything you want within these rows. If you want to add in new content, like an image or a text or whatever module you want, just hover over your current module and press on this plus icon down here, or when it's too small, it's over there. Click on it and you can choose from any of these modules that Divi has to offer. But not only that, you can also add in an entire new row inside of this row where your module is. So this gives you extreme flexibility. If you want to style a module in Divi, just click on the specific module. And then on the right side, we can see this specific module as an image. You can go to content, change everything you want over here, but you can also go to design. In the design, you can change the alignment, the sizing, the spacing, all these things that makes your life as a website owner way more easier. And finally, there's also the advanced tab, which you can change even more things. Now, these three tabs, content, design, and advanced, you will not only see with modules, but also if I go to my row settings, there we are, content, design, and advanced. If you want to change a row content, go over there and change the column structure straight from within these sections. Really awesome. If you want to see how this entire page has been built up, or you just want to navigate quickly, especially useful with very long pages, you go over here on the left side to Layers. Open it up and you can see the sections that you have. You can click on it and you go immediately, you jump to that specific section, or you can open it up and then you can go to the specific column and the modules that are inside of it. If you want to rename them, just go over here to this section, for example, click on it again, and then you can change it to Hero. And this makes it very easy to navigate throughout your entire page. If you give them the right names, you can also search your layout, or you can click on Open All, and you can see exactly how your page is being built up at the backend. There is also another way. Go over here and click on the wireframe or Shift W on your keyboard. Here we can see exactly how our website being built up, but then it's a wireframe view. Now this is very useful if you have put one module behind another one, you're playing with z-indexes and scrolling things, then this is the best option to quickly pinpoint the right module, row or section. It's very easy now to quickly see what font or colors or numbers you have been using inside of a module, section or row. Just click over here on the inspector and then we go to anything you want, for example, this module. You can see the colors, the numbers you've been using and the fonts, but also this entire section. It will now show you all the colors that has been used inside of this entire section and rows and modules inside one go. This is very easy to just pick out that color or that font that you have just been using and you didn't know what you used right now. If you want to optimize your Divi website for mobiles, tablets and all different kinds of screens, you just click over here on the top and it easily switches immediately to tablet mode and phone mode. There we go. And you can also make this entirely responsive the way you want it. For example, if you think this is not the right custom size, then just change it to 350, press enter, and it's been immediately changed. You can also do it manually by just dragging your screen around. And this way you can completely optimize it for different screen sizes. This had some really great improvement versus Divi 4. Remember when you click on it and it just loaded and you were some other section of the page? Oh, it was horrible and it took forever. This makes life a lot easier. It's very easy to duplicate or copy entire modules, rows and sections inside of your website. Just hover over the thing you want to copy, right click on it and press copy module. Go anywhere else to another page or another section and paste it in over there, right click and press over here on paste module or Ctrl V on your keyboard. And then you have the exact same module. This also works with sections and rows. You can also just hover over it and press on this duplicate module button. There we go. Also with the entire section, just duplicate it. And now when you scroll down, it has been duplicated over here. But that's not all. You can also right click on it and copy the attributes. It means the styling of your entire module, section or row. And you can go anywhere else and paste it in the exact same thing. There's also another way to extend the attributes to this row, this section, or the entire page or website. This way you make sure that everything looks the same. If you're building your website, you want to use variables. On the left side, you can click over here to the variable manager. In here, you can see a few different things. We have, for example, the colors, usually also known as the global fonts, and the global colors, all the colors you have inside of your website, you can give them a primary color, secondary heading. What's the use of this? Well, if you ever decide to change this color, you just have to change it over here and throughout your entire website, this color will be changed automatically. It's also possible with fonts. But with global variables, you can do even more. You can also create global links. Just add them in somewhere on your website, change your links in your global variables, and it will be changed throughout your entire website. The same is with images, even text and numbers. You can put in, for example, the amount of employees and then you just change them once in a while. An entire website will be changed if you change the global variables. Very useful. If you ever want to use your global font or color, just click on the specific module, go to design. For example, I want to change the title text color. Then we scroll down and over here we can see our color. Then you click over here on the variable manager and you can choose any global color you have put inside of the manager. When working on your website, you want to make use of the theme builder. just go over here to Divi, and here is the theme builder. Here you can build global headers, global footers, but also custom bodies, and you can assign them to different pages, categories, or type of pages within your website. For example, I have created a global header. You can just click on the edit button, and this is the place where I build and control my header throughout all my website pages. If you want to assign them to different pages, for example, this custom body I have created is only for products on my e-commerce website. So every product will look like this. This is extremely useful when you have, for example, an e-commerce website. You don't have to change every single product by hand, which is a complete weird way to build your website. With the theme builder, you can create anything you want and it will be used throughout your entire website. If you want to assign these layouts to different kinds of pages, go over here and click Manage Template Assignments. Here we go. You can just select any page you want and make sure that the theme builder only puts on this design on this specific page, product, category, whatever you want. If you made a mistake and you want to undo the change or just go back in history, maybe 20 steps back, that's no problem. Just go over here, there's a undo button, or use Ctrl Z on your keyboard. But you can also go over here to the history, and here we can just go back to the loaded pages. That is also possible. But if you've already saved your layout, then you need to go back to the revisions. And that's something that Divi 5 has not yet integrated in here, but you can always do this in the dashboard of WordPress itself. If you want to import design templates from Elegant Themes themselves, you are in for a treat, because if you click on this plus icon and you choose this pre-made layout, you can see 370 layout packs with almost 7,000 layouts available for you just to cherry pick whatever you want and import it straight into your page. Have you ever seen this amount of free templates included in your standard license with a page builder? Me neither. If you want to use such a layout, just click on it and then you go over here to the specific layout details, and you have all different kinds of pages, which you can just click on it. And if you click on it, you can see it over here, what is happening. And you can just use this layout and just import it. Choose if you want to import your presets, yes or no, and press on import. And there you go, it's just being loaded inside of your website. And there you go, the entire layout has been put inside of my Divi website, just like that. Hey, thank you for watching. If you've liked this video, hit that thumbs up for me, it would really help me. And if you want to learn how to create a very beautiful design, not this one, but a brand new one in Divi 5, then go to this next video and I'll show you exactly how to create this beautiful website within Divi 5 and learn a new skill. Hope to see you in this next video. If you have any questions, drop it down in the comments. I'll always reply.